What up, B? Alright, my older masculines, who would consider themselves a hierophant, what the fuck are you doing? That's all, what are you doing? They're, like, my team is telling me you know better. Like, you're a hierophant in the way that you are very smart, you know a lot, you've been through a lot. You have the ability to make good choices and the ability to have good judgment. What are you doing? They have this Queen of Swords out. Queen of Swords energy out. And my team is literally saying that you have this pull to leave a situation or a job or a relationship. You have this pull, and they're saying that it's your soul telling you you're not supposed to be where you're at. I mean, there's no other way to say it. You know you're not supposed to be where you're at, but you're still there. There's this Queen of Swords energy, and she is very manipulative, and she can be very bitter, and she could be critical about you, like very critical about you. And they're putting you in this Six of Swords, but this wishy-washy, like, oh, I know I need to leave, but, oh, I need to, no. Fuck, you're at the stage where you know better, do better. You know what you need to do, so go do it. They're saying that once you pick up and leave, they have the Emperor being bridged between the Fool and the Queen of Swords. And they're literally saying that your newfound beginning only occurs after you make that decision to leave. They're calling you clouded. They're saying that when you leave, you will start to embody back again, they're saying, your Emperor. Because I guess at one time you were Mr. In Charge. You were stable to a point. You were the one holding the reins to your chariot, is the way that they're saying it. Like, you were the one driving the show. But they're saying that this Queen of Swords gave you the illusion and made you pass off your control for security. And they're saying that you made the swap, hesitantly, but you made the swap with this Queen of Swords energy. And they're saying now it's time for you to take back control because you're not where you need to be. But they're saying that after you do that and you get back in control of your life, of your surroundings, of yourself, this is going to bridge not only your emotional balance with the Eight of Cups out here, but it's also your Ace of Wands. Your new fiery passion is going to be lit inside yourself. You're actually going to be following your chariot if you do this. And they're just talking about how this is a heavy conflicted situation for you. So this could be an intimate relationship, potentially, or it could just be a business something, like a business deal. But at the end of the day, they're saying this leaving of is inevitable. You need to regain control and security within yourself, and you need to start grabbing the reins to your journey, to your existence again. And they're saying the only way you can do this is by leaving this bitter, manipulative energy, because truly all of it is clouding your decision. And it's not that you don't feel anything. And this is something that I've realized in my lifetime. It's not that you don't feel anything for this person. That's not it. Because that's not how relationships work, baby. It's that you do. But it's quite literally, the goods don't outweigh the bad. Love doesn't look like that. And that's the point. That's what my team is saying. Love doesn't look like that. And you can't love yourself and be in an outward love relationship like that. They're saying that you know what you need to do, and this is going to spark this leaving of that space. This leaving of that space is going to spark your new beginning, your new birth, and that's where you're going to get that new fiery passion, that new flame, but you're going to return it back to yourself. Because you had it beforehand. You did. You had it. You just lost it along the way because you did a swap that wasn't in your favor. And that's okay. But now it's time to fix it. All right.